Hey everyone, this is Allie with the support team here at Tripleseat. Today we're going to talk about how to adjust your billing details and your menu item categories and settings. Billing details are typically the percentage-based taxes and fees that are applied on top of your line items or your charges. Billing details count towards the grand total for your events. They do not count towards the actual sales. Popular examples of billing details would be sales tax, admin fee, and gratuity. Menu item categories are used to categorize your individual line items or charges for reporting and financial purposes. Popular examples of menu item categories include food, beverage, room rental, and AV equipment. Having menu item categories set up in Tripleseat will ensure that your charges are billing the way you need them to and will allow for accurate reporting. For example, your food items might have a gratuity applied while your room rental might not. Heading into a set of event documents I had started earlier, we can see that there are food and beverage line items added. If you expand each item on the right, you can see what menu item category belongs to each item and the subsequent billing details that have been applied. If items are added by pick list, the category will automatically be assigned. If you add a line item by freehand, you will need to make sure that you manually assign a menu item category, which will auto-assign billing details for you. If desired, you can adjust the billing of each item per event. As I am in an event document making this change, note that this will not affect settings. Scrolling down to this event document's billing widget, here we can see the menu item category totals in addition to all of the billing details. We can adjust the percentages of billing details per event, or we can take them off completely from just this event. For instance, if there isn't going to be any gratuity on this event, we could set the amount to zero, or we could delete the line by clicking on the red trash can to the right. This will only make the change on this event, and again, will not affect your settings. If you need to adjust either the billing details or menu item categories for your group, you'll need the appropriate settings access to do so. Starting with billing details, head into settings and then select billing details. Here, you can add new billing details or edit any existing by clicking edit. Let's add an admin fee. Click the new document billing button and give it a name. You can add a different internal name if you'd like, which will only be seen internally by your team. The value can either be a percentage or a flat amount. Next, if you would like this billing detail to be included in an item's price, check off the box next to inclusive. If you have multiple locations with an admin fee, but different amounts, you can indicate the different amounts here. Be sure to click save after entering. Let's say we need to add tax to this admin fee. If you need to apply billing details to each other, click on the billing detail being applied and check off the billing detail it's being applied to. So since we are applying sales tax to the admin fee, we will check off admin fee from within the sales tax billing detail. Now that we have added a new billing detail, we need to tell the system what types of items should have this admin fee applied on top of them. Head back into your settings and click into menu item categories. Here are the existing categories for our site. We can add, delete, and edit as needed. We will click into any of the menu item categories that need this admin fee added. Anytime we adjust billing details within a menu item category or add a new menu item category entirely, the next step will be updating any existing pick lists that have items with this updated category. To do so, we'll head back into our settings and then into pick lists. Here you can see this existing food pick list has a sales tax and a gratuity applied to it. Although we updated food to include admin fee in the category settings, this will not automatically update existing pick lists. If this pick list is mostly one category, we can use the mass assign option to quickly reassign the pick list to include the admin fee. And of course, with any items that need a different category assigned, we can manually adjust per line item. The last step to take is now adding the newly added admin fee as a billing detail to your document billing widget so it appears by default in each set of event documents created moving forward. Check out our document templates and layouts video for more information on how to do this. The next time you add from your updated pick list, the items will automatically have an admin fee applied. Newly created event documents will include the admin fee in this billing widget, and this admin fee will be taxed by default. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions or need help setting up your financials, please contact our support team at support@tripleseat.com or by clicking on the help and questions button on the top right corner of any screen in Tripleseat.